Today I want to help you get more consistency with your iron shots in particular. Okay, and I want to draw upon one area that I see on a day-to-day basis with a lot of my clients where they really struggle to understand how the arms and the body work together in the swing. Okay, so what we're looking for, well, you know, if we think about our setup here, we're creating this sort of V-shape here in our arms. And the idea is that if we can maintain that throughout our swing, we are going to get some level of consistency. So if we think about what we're looking for in the backswing, we want that left arm to be pretty straight there. We want the body rotating and staying in that sort of centered pivot, if you like. And then as we're coming down, we want that arm structure to stay together. We want that body opening. We want that lovely extension through the ball into that balanced finish. And it's not what I see on a day-to-day basis. So what I see a lot of is a lot of left arm collapsing, trail arm collapsing, very much in this position here. And what happens there is your lever becomes your elbow and not the wrist, okay? So we see with good players maintaining that arm structure, creating that nice wrist hinge, and then as they're coming down, that unwinding of the body allows the club to get into that delivery position that we would expect England golfers, where that club's nicely on plane, we can create optimal striking, distance and accuracy, okay? What else do we see? Well, we also see a lot of this move here where we get very disconnected in the swing. We see a lot of early releases and all of this inaccuracies within our arm structure creates a lot of inconsistency, okay? You might have some good days, but you'll have a lot of bad days as well, okay? So the principle I want to draw on is connection, okay? So the connection is how the arms and the body work together. You know, we've seen, certainly in Ben Hogan's famous book, The Modern Fundamentals of Golf, he always felt like his arms were sort of tied together in this position here. And that always allowed him to rotate the body, keep the arm structure together, and really helped him with that consistency. So what I've got here is a smart ball, okay? So we're gonna pop that over our neck and we're gonna place that in our forearms. So from this position here, it allows us to first of all get that correct setup position where the arms feel like they're squeezing together. And then we're gonna start off making some half swings without a club, really getting a feel for how the arms stay connected in the backswing, in down into impact and into that follow through position. I'm going to insert a caption of one of my recent students, Jay, who has done this in a recent lesson, and you'll see some huge benefits there. And what it really allowed him to do was actually, in the backswing, allowed him to keep that left arm straight. It allowed him to retain his angles. And then for him, most importantly, allowed him to get that shaft lean that we're all looking for with good iron play, get that nice strike in there, descending blow, and get that lovely extension coming through. Okay, so once we've got that, then it's about trying to build in some half swings. Okay, so from here, again, taking that correct setup, building in some half swings, and really allowing the body to rotate, the club to set, feeling the rotation, and then most of all, extending through. Okay, so if we just hit a couple of shots here, so from a good setup position, we're just going to keep the arms squeezed together and then extend nicely through. What you'll start to feel there is a real kind of connection between the body and the arms, okay? And all of a sudden the body will start to control it. I think what we find in a lot of guys that struggle is that the arms tend to control the body. We overhinge, we get that early release, lose connection, and this one simple drill can make all the difference, okay? So if we now, as you say, as you start to play and practice more, hit a few shots with this, and what you can do is just build into these full shots, really get a sensation for hinging up, our elbows squeezing together, and then extending through, and you'll get that sort of held off follow through, similar to Tommy Fleetwood, where you'll just get into that nice position, hinge it up, and then extend through. And you'll really start to get a feel for what we're trying to do, trying to get that connection within the swing, and I'm sure you will gain a lot of consistency in your golf game. As always, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll look forward to seeing you again very soon.